What is up, ladies and gentlemen of the interwebs? My name is Larry, aka LCD, and today I wanted to make a quick video talking about how demanding The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt is right now for PCs. Just right off the bat, this might be the most demanding PC game ever made to date. I know this goes all the way back to the running gag back in the old days where can your computer run Crysis? Not even NASA can run Crysis, right? On high settings or something like that. It was hilarious. That was the running gag for the longest time because Crysis literally was the best benchmark, back in the early 2000s, 2005, 2006 or whatever. And I think that The Witcher 3 is absolutely ridiculous when it comes to benchmarking. The Witcher 3 might become like the new benchmark standard for at least a few years until something takes its place. This game is absolutely ridiculous in terms of graphics quality. It looks amazing, and a lot of people have been posting benchmarks on YouTube saying how their systems are having a really, really tough time running this game on ultra or even high. Even some people are struggling to run it on medium and low settings, and they have really, really good systems. I can tell you guys right off the bat that I am running two GTX 760s in SLI mode, an i7-4790K, 8 gigs of RAM, and a 256 gig solid state drive. And I've already done some tests myself, and I am struggling to run this game, even with my 760 SLI setup. However, I am going to be upgrading to the new GTX 980 Ti, a single card that is actually supposed to be coming out this Tuesday on June 2nd, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't really keep up. I'm not a big technology guy, but I do know my way around a computer. So, I heard the GTX 980 Ti is going to be just a little bit better than a regular 980, and then also a little bit less powerful than a Titan X. That's the thing about the Titan X, is that even people with Titan X's are having trouble running this game on Ultra without turning off Hairworks and things like that. So I just want to give you guys a quick idea about how I run this game. So I'm just going to turn everything to Ultra, turn everything to Medium, turn everything to High, turn everything to Low, and see how actually well I can run this game. I can tell you right off the bat that I can't run this game very well. Even on very, very, very low settings, I can only average about 35 to 40 frames per second, which is kind of bad for a 760 SLI setup. So I'm using my Xbox One controller right now. So I'm going to go ahead and go to Options. Gameplay, or not gameplay, video, graphics, turn everything to low, go to pause processing, turn everything to low, and right now I'm sitting at about 35 to 40 frames per second on everything on low. It looks terrible. It still feels terrible not being able to run this 60. So now let's go to video, graphics, we'll go to medium. Turn post-processing to medium as well. And we dipped about a good 10 frames. We're sitting about 25 to 30 right now. Looks a tad bit better. Still feels terrible though. Now we go to options, video once more. Now we turn everything to high. And we lost about another good 5 to 7 frames. Now we're sitting about 20 to 22. And once more, we go down to video, graphics, turn it to ultra, post-processing is already on high. We're just going to turn ambient occlusion up to high, HBAO. And we're getting a whopping 15 frames per second, sometimes dipping down to 12 frames per second. You guys can see the FPS counter on the bottom right. I'm using the Steam built-in beta FPS counter. I like this Steam FPS counter because it's not intrusive, it's not in the way, it just looks pretty good. So that's really nice. So yeah, this looks okay. You can tell my graphics cards are having a really tough time running this game, because you can see everything's all pixelated. It's just not able to render everything correctly because it's just not able to handle this game. So that's how demanding this game can be. In GTX 760s are no slouch. These are not normal GTX 760s either. These are the 4 GB super clocked edition GTX 760s and running an SLI. So if that gives you any kind of indication about how demanding this game is, hopefully you now have some idea. Like I said, this game is kind of ridiculous. I can't even play the game until I get my freaking new graphics card, the 980 Ti, so... it really sucks that I can't enjoy the game like I want to. I mean, I'd have to play the game at super low and still be barely getting 40 frames per second. So that's no fun, right? So I didn't want to buy the console versions because I wanted to experience this game how it actually is supposed to be experienced. You know, 60 frames per second, full 1080p, freaking, you know, ultra settings. And I will be able to do that hopefully with the 980 Ti. I've heard that most GTX 980s right now are able to run the game on Ultra. You just have to turn off Hairworks and post-processing, and it should run very, very smoothly and also look good as well. So with that being said, guys, that's going to conclude this video. Hopefully this gave you some kind of indication about how demanding The Witcher 3 actually is. This will become the new benchmark standard for PCs going forward for the next couple of years, I'm sure, unless some other demanding game comes out soon that we just aren't aware of yet. But for now, this game is ridiculous, and I can't wait to dive into it once I get my new graphics card. If you guys have any suggestions for me or have any questions, please let me know in the comment section below. My name is LCD. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Thanks for watching.